We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And they make the stop at the 27. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
And there's not much he could do to get away from the junior safety on that play.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. There's a strike complete. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Black five.
They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting him in the backfield.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 33.
Three down.
Here we go. Oh.
Green nine.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And down he goes. Around the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. That'll bring up 32.
He might have a chance. Fumble. That was a close one, but the ball goes out of bounds.
They got a little sloppy here with their ball handling. It's a good thing they were near the sideline. Otherwise, the defense could have pounced on that football.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after review, they decide that this call should be reversed. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Check 83. Ball's going to 83.
They hand it off again. Runs it left for a decent gain.
That brings him second and five.
And he's met immediately.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That makes it 37.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Three down.
Here we go. Oh, here we go.
Green nine. Green 50.
He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Minnesota's coaching staff so confident. They know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country, and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brad, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback of this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute. Now he took the pitch there and was able to get the first down. It's a nice option play.
First down.
From their own 44-yard line. First down.
Let's go. Hey, Mike.
Green nine.
Tackle made to the 39-yard line. At the 44.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings up 30.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Fires it out. A That's a great tackle at the 43.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
He'll get it again. The back gets three on the carry.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 40. And he's level at the 36.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Takes the ball inside, and he carries the ball for a nice gain. From the 32-yard line, first down. Passes, and it's almost picked off.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
10th play of the drive. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. And he's tackled at the 19-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 19. He's on the run. He makes his way out to about the 9. Here's the 12th play of the drive.
You talk about a masterpiece. This offense right now is working exactly the way they had planned all week long. You're putting so much time as an offensive coordinator, as an offensive staff, on what you think might work, and you put it out there and you wonder, how many adjustments are we going to have to make? Right now, this offense...
Touchdown, Golden Gophers! And he adds the extra point. It was a 13-play, 80-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 7-0. Golden Gophers are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. 3-yard gain by the running back.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it second and 7.
There are 3 quarters remaining. The Golden Gophers with a touchdown lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2.
Cover tight. Four down. Mike's number one.
Here we go. X7. Check. Dancer. Go.
Out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
That'll make it 3-5.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Four down. Here we go. Oh,
black five. Black.
And he is drilled to the 37-yard line.
The offense only got the first down by about a yard, but I'm sure they'll be happy with the new set of downs.
Tackles him hard at the 45-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Four down. So Mike's number one.
Red 2. Blue 4.
Here he goes. throws. Makes it to the 41. Run there as they work the outside.
That brings them second and five.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down.
Red two.
They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Steps out of bounds, right around the 22-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 22. Fires out to his wideout. He's knocked out of bounds, around the 6-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. He's got the tight end again. Brought down around the 4-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and goal.
This is the 11th play of this drive. It's third and goal from the 3-yard line.
Black five, go!
Let it go, and it's caught for the touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. So a 12-play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
We're even at 7 in this one. He sends this one deep, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He's taken down at the 33-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Two minutes to go in the half.
Let's go. Hey, hey, Mike 40, Mike 40.
Larry. Go!
Has some daylight. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Red two, green.
A junior makes the catch.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
From the 47-yard line, it's first down. He scrambles, runs with it, and he's got room. He's taken down at about the 33-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. First down.
Tight right. Four down. 40's the mark. Squeeze.
Red two.
It's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Red two, yellow three, yellow three.
And he can't get away from the pressure. Steps out at the 25-yard line. So they're going to go for it here. He's on the run. Slides down. So they run it on fourth down, and they pick up the first.
Boy, big play there, Brad. You know, a lot of times on fourth down, you'll see the ball carrier panic, but not this guy. This is a good job of showing patience and letting the run develop.
The 10 gains his way to the 7-yard line.
Easy, easy. Flair, flair.
That makes it first and goal.
Black five, black five. Yellow three. Yellow.
Go.
Kill, kill, kill. Flair.
That brings up second and goal.
And they get the sack.
Kill, kill, kill. Three.
That makes us third and goal.
Quick pass, intercepted. And they'll return this one all the way.
It's a good play when the corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
From their own 44-yard line. First down.
Three down, three down.
And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. They'll make the sack. So at the end of the half, we get a tie game at 7-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
The first half pretty much devoid of big offensive plays. It's not really what we expected to see with these two teams, both capable of getting yards and chunks of scoring very quickly. So when you have playmakers who are bottled up for an entire half, what's the frustration level like for them?
Oh, it starts to get high. And as a defense, you love it. You sense it. You feed off of it because, well, you think about it. You got running backs that are used to making one guy miss, two guys miss, take it to the house. Well, now you're making one guy miss, two guys miss, and you're like, wait, a third guy's coming in? I mean, they're tackling. So what? You're used to receivers being able to go up over DBs and make big plays, and you got DBs hanging with you and batting the ball down. And so it's just, it puts you in a situation where you're like, wait, this isn't supposed to happen. A little bit of doubt creeps in because usually you're just going up and down the field, nobody's stopping you. And you, so in your mind, you think, I'm invincible. I'm not capable of being stopped.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
And the second half just about set to get started. We're dead even. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 26.
Check back 40. Check back 40. Red two.
first down.
Call it a gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Nice run there. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Keep 15.
Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
That's not what you hope for your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Gets out to around the 38. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Quick throw, and down he goes at the 28-yard line. It's second and five here. Ball on the 28. And he shoved out of bounds at the 24. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
Red two, green.
They keep it on the ground, and a great tackle right there.
Loss of one on the play. Fourth down.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
Mike one.
Go. Again with the run. They don't get it. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost them the possession. They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it. Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. There's a strike complete. Tackle right around the 46-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
That's a great tackle at the 46. From their own 46-yard line, it's second down. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Scrambling around. And now he's going to improvise. Slides down to the ground. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 23.
Red two. Go.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Let's see if they can put that last interception behind them and do something different this time in the red zone. Gets to about the 14-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Good outside run there.
He decided to keep it himself this time on the option, and he managed to get upfield and pick up the first down.
This is the ninth play of this drive. And he's tackled around the 15-yard line. And that run got stuck.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
So with one quarter remaining, we're even at 7 in this one. All tied up, and we head to the all-important fourth quarter.
Four down. 40's Mike. 40's Mike. Red.
Run. And they make the stop right around the 12-yard line. It's the 11th play of the drive.
You've got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
Tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Right back to the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
Loss of two on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 35. Back to the running back, and he gets nowhere.
Well, I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen, and he's level at the 38-yard line. The D sniffs out the screen pass and holds him to a short gain.
Contain, contain, contain. That's the only way you can shut down a guy with 4-2 speed.
Oh, excellent punt. He takes it in at the 14. Tackle at the 21-yard line. A score here might effectively end this one. Minnesota up 7 points. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Laterals back. There's a fumble. And the offense picks it up. He's tackled at the 20. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's taken down at the 23. The Spartans use their second timeout. Booming kick. He's taken down at the 36. Michigan State's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Well, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on. Second and 10. Ball on the 36. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Catches it, and that's all. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
The 32-yard line. 7-yard gain, and that'll be a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
Just throws this one away. From the 32-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. He's taken down at the 26.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
They come out in an empty backfield. Rifles it right. Throws quickly into the end zone. Caught for the touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first? The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Not much time left on the clock, and we've got a great one going. We are tied at 14. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? He's out of bounds, right around the 26-yard line. It's second and nine. Ball on the 26-yard line. He's going to air it long. And he's got the junior. And down he goes, around the 26-yard line. The Golden Gophers will use their first time out of the half. After a decent pickup, Minnesota is going to have to use their second time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Go four! Blue four! Blue four!
Puts it right in his hands. Touchdown. Thank you. Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Minnesota with a 6-point lead. And he converts the extra point. A 4-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
He just drills this one. And with time winding down, they probably won't let this return man field the ball. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
Not much time to be creative here. They've got to get the ball into the end zone.
The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Throw is incomplete. Broken up. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Well, you never know what can happen in college football, so I wouldn't be surprised by anything here. Either way, it should be exciting. He lets it fly. Here comes the pressure. That tackle just sealed the deal. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Golden Gophers get the win, 21-14. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.